Today the church celebrates the feast of Saint Thomas, the apostle. He was an outstanding and outspoken apostle, known to have said to Christ, "We do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And again he would say to other apostles, "Let us go and die with him." To tell you the faith of the man we are celebrating today, and the church asks God that through his intercession, we may be outspoken disciples of Christ, bringing men and women to faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate this sacred mystery worthy, we call to mind ourselves and ask God for pardon.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
We
praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayers. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may glory in the feast of the blessed Apostle Thomas, so that we may always be sustained by his intercession, and believing may have life, in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, whom Thomas acknowledged as the Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Proclamation from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you are no longer strangers or sojourners, but you are fellow citizens with the holy ones and members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the capstone. Through him, the whole structure is held together and grows into a temple sacred in the Lord. In you also are being built together into a dwelling place of God in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial song, go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Oh.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify Him, all you peoples.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
For steadfast is His kindness for us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Please stand. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
You believe in me, Thomas, because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are those who have not seen, but still believe.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
Your
a proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with him when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But Thomas said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your fingers here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, God, Jesus Christ. Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Dear friends, today as we celebrate the Feast of St. Thomas, the Gospel reading is about the doubt that Thomas expressed regarding the resurrection of Christ. And Thomas, because of this, has been popularly known or famously known as the Doubting Thomas, the one who doubted the resurrection of Christ. But the church celebrates Thomas today because he did more than doubting the resurrection of Christ. His doubt did not separate him from Christ, rather it led to a deeper faith in the risen Lord, where he made that beautiful declaration. Of course, we use it at devotions and masses, "My Lord and my God." His doubt led him deeper faith in Christ Jesus. St. Thomas is known to have brought the good news to the people of the modern day India and Pakistan. That was where he ministered, and he died for the same faith that he doubted before. Today the church upholds him with a great honor, with great dignity. For he was a man true to his word. Dear friends, we are in a time that it could be difficult to believe. It could be difficult to believe in people, sometimes in ourselves, sometimes in just everything. Take for instance the social media that we have, the various information that comes into it. We are bombarded on Facebook with different opinions. We see different information about the same thing. And sometimes we don't know which one is true, which one to believe. We live in a time that you turn on the television, you hear one thing, and another person says a different thing. Each station has versions of truth, and you just don't know which one to hold on to. We live in a time you hear expressions of alternative truth, and you wonder, are you in a different world? And some people are in a different world. Why different realities? So it is difficult to believe. And sometimes we see ourselves as Thomas. But there is one truth. Inasmuch as Thomas doubted and wondered, the truth eventually revealed himself to Thomas. And Thomas came to believe in that very truth. Jesus, the truth. Jesus, the life. And Jesus, the resurrection. Thomas came to believe in him, and he exclaimed, "My Lord and my God." And when Thomas was convinced of the faith, he went out and preached to the people of India, to the people of Pakistan, and they came to faith in Christ. Just as other apostles came to us and brought the faith to our people. And now we are in that same faith. And St. Paul in the first reading says, founded on the faith of the apostles. We are founded on the faith of Thomas, on the faith of the apostles. And Jesus said in the gospel reading, how blessed are we who did not see him, but we have come to believe. On the faith of Thomas, on the faith of the apostles. How blessed are we? Dear friends, we are indeed blessed because look at this church. We are of different families, different backgrounds, but we come together to be a family. We sit together, we chat, we talk, and we dine together as one family. What a blessing could be more than that? Being in the company of people who believe. Being in the company of loved ones who are not your members, your family members, or from your town. But you all come together. Our first reading says, it is the most beautiful thing. For Christ is the reason for this. He is the cornerstone of this formation. Is the cornerstone of this house we have built. And based upon that, none of us should count himself or herself as a stranger or a sojourner because you are of a different family, a different background. You should not see yourself in the house of God as sojourners. But it is as if St. Paul should write that message to some of us individually. Because sometimes we see ourselves as strangers, as sojourners in the house of God. And we come to the church and we go back just the way we came. Nothing changes. And we add nothing to it. We bring nothing to it and we take nothing out from it. Sometimes we describe those people as bench warmers. And they do their work very well. They warm the benches very well. And thank God for cold season, they warm the benches so that those who come for mass will have good warmth. But dear friends, St. Paul invites us to be more than bench warmers, for we are called to a faith that is founded by Christ. And Christ is constantly at work, so should we be at work. But we can only do our work because of faith, on account of faith, the kind of faith we have in Christ. So we pray today and ask God that we may be people of faith, we may grow daily in faith. Our daily experience may not impose doubt on us, But the love of God may conquer every form of doubt, every form of fear in us, so that we may be able to express our faith freely in Christ, knowing that we are not strangers or sojourners, but we are citizens. May the Lord bless his word through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May we rise for the prayer of the faith. Dear friends, let us make our prayers known to God, who is able to grant all our desires.
Father, the church, that it forever remain free from evil and be made perfect in love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the world, the peace that only comes from the Lord and radiates from the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all travelers and pilgrims, that they have a safe journey, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that we benefit from their ministry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people to realize human life from conception to natural death is a God-given right, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Of all who have died, that they may find the Jesus and the kingdom of light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For your own personal intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, do with favor upon the prayers which your children make known to you. Grant them not according to our desires, but according to your riches in glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, the fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, the fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become a spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause
of the Church. We render you, O Lord, the service that is your due, humbly imploring you to keep safe your gifts in us, as we honor the confession of the Apostles and Thomas, and offer you a sacrifice of praise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until we come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Daniel our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Alvin Kulak. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ."
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Now let us share a sign of peace with each other.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. O God, as we truly receive in this sacrament the body of your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that we may recognize him with the Apostle Thomas by faith as our Lord and our God, and proclaim him by our deeds and by our life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Yes, there will be a Mass tomorrow morning for the 4th of July. If you're not here, I welcome you to come to be here with Mass. Father and I will also have a great 4th of July.
Thank you,
Archie. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who has granted you to stand firm on apostolic foundation, graciously bless you through the glorious merits of the Holy Apostle Thomas. Amen.
Amen.
And may he who endowed you with the teaching and example of apostles make you, under their protection, witnesses to the truth before all. Amen.
Amen.
So that through the intercession of the apostles, you may inherit the eternal homeland. For by their teaching, you possess firmness of faith. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.